Hey folks, Marco here. This is not a tutorial, lecture, or a course. This is a crash course. Used automatic 1111 before? Good, because I will rely on your knowledge to go over text-to-image, outpainting, inpainting, and detailing in ComfyUI. And all you need to follow along is ComfyUI and Custom Node Manager installed. There are plenty of YouTube guides showing you how to install it. You will also need a set of custom nodes called Impact Pack, which you can use Node Manager to download. These are developed by none other than the good doctor himself, the one who developed the manager, one and the same. However, if you wish to replicate my results exactly, then pause the video and grab these as well. And that's it for the intro. Let's get started. So let's begin with a clear canvas. So I will double click, type load checkpoint, and then I'm going to choose CyberRealistic version 5. And now we're going to construct a basic pipe. I will double click and type TOB, and then I connect these three into the pipe. So all that's left is positive and negative. So what does the pipe do? Instead of having five lines across the workflow, it combines them into a single one. It just makes your workflows a lot more tidy. Regardless of which user interface you use, checkpoints you download from Civitai typically have three parts in them. Model, which I believe is constructed from a UNet, that is the bit that actually does the diffusion for us. Then you have clip, which converts your text prompt into a language that AI can understand. And then autoencoder converts image from latent space into pixel space and vice versa. To get the prompt, I'm going to click and drag clip, let go, and then choose clip text encode. If you click and drag and your list of suggested nodes is shorter than mine, all you have to do is go into settings and then change it from, I think the default value is 5, to something more, I have 40. This controls how many node suggestions you will get. Nodes can be copy-pasted, Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V, and nodes can also be pasted with their input connections. So instead of Ctrl-V, what I will press is Ctrl-Shift-V. Let's call the first one positive prompt, and the next one negative prompt. We can make them a little smaller. Then we can connect them as a positive negative here. You can move across the canvas by clicking and dragging like this. And if you need to select multiple nodes at once, you can hold down Control and then click and drag. With multiple nodes selected, if you hold down Shift and click on any of them and drag, then that lets you drag them as a group. Speaking of which, when you have multiple nodes selected, if you right-click on the canvas, you can click this option that says Add Group for selected nodes, and then moving these nodes around now becomes a lot easier. Let's give this group some sort of a name, inputs, and we can change the color as well. Now let's generate something. I will double-click here and type Impact K, then choose the first option. Then I will drag basic pipe into here. I will use the prompt that I have already prepared. If you want, you can pause the video and type this up. Now let's set some parameters. So you will recognize these settings more or less the same as you've seen in automatic 1111. I will choose seed fixed. I will keep steps to 20, CFG 8, choose 2M. And with the power of hindsight, I will set this seed to 6. Now you will notice that Sampler also requires a latent image to be used as input. This is somewhat different from automatic 1111, or rather, automatic 1111 does this for you. You set the width and height you want, and it generates image in this resolution, but behind the scenes, it uses image as input alongside your prompt. In ComfyUI, that is a little bit more specific. When I first learned of this, I was quite surprised, because what that means is, under the hood, every text-to-image workflow is really image-to-image. There is always image in and image out. Even if the input image is a bunch of noise or latent zeros or whatever, it's still image in, image out. So let us load empty latent. And I will set width to be 288. If you remember, I said VAE is what converts latent images into pixel images, because we can only see pixels. To decode latent back into pixels, I will choose VAE decode. I connect autoencoder, and then I will preview the image. I hit Control Enter, which runs the workflow, and this is our output. Now let's do some outpainting. I'm going to copy the inputs here and then paste them somewhere empty, like here, Ctrl-V. And while they're all selected, I will add them to a group. I will change the color to something else, perhaps brown, and then all this inpainting inputs. Change the checkpoint to inpainting, and I will remove the prompt. Just leave them blank for this. Now going back to my image, I'm going to use a node for outpainting. So if I double click and I type the word outpaint, I should get only one node, pad image for outpainting. If you have done outpainting in automatic 1111, then you are already familiar with what this does. But let me show you. If I enter 224 here, and then, well, you can see for yourself, I run this. So to do sampling, we are going to need another one of these. So I will just copy paste here. And just like we decoded latent into pixels, we will encode pixels into latent. For outpainting and inpainting, we need VAE encode for inpaint. So purple connects with purple, green connects with green, and we need autoencoder here. So I can just drag it from this end. Another useful feature to keep your workflow tidy are reroute nodes. Drag this one here, and choose reroute, and then connect it again. Now let me tidy this up a little bit. And now we can decode the latent back into pixels. So this was outpainting, but what about inpainting? Well, again, I'm going to select my sampler and just copy it over here. Basic pipe, which you can just continue on to here. And then I'm going to double click and type the word bridge. And choose the first one here. Just like before, we're going to need this same node for inpainting, and this bridge will provide us with mask. Let me show you what I mean. Once you make all these connections, basically what happens is when you run the workflow, at this point it sort of will pause, and it will let you essentially make a mask, which then gets passed on. For purposes of this video, let's say we want to get rid of this plate here. So I'm going to right click on this and then open in mask editor, and then I'm going to apply mask to it and then save to node. So instead of saving the image and then loading it and then applying the mask, this node saves the image in a temporary location, lets you apply the mask, and then resumes with your workflow. So this is the node I would normally use. However, to all the perfectionists out there who are following along and want your mask to match with mine down to the last pixel, I have saved image that you can use. So instead of this bridge, I wanted you to be aware of it, but for purposes of this video, we're not gonna actually use it to let you follow along. We're going to use image that I have saved. So blue to blue, connect green to green. If you don't want to delete the node, you can mute it by pressing Ctrl M. It mutes and unmutes the node. Now we go back to our sampler, decode the latent, red to red, and then we choose preview. I press Ctrl Enter, and the object is gone. Now, what if I want a cat to be sitting on the bench right next to the pizza? Again, I will provide you with a mask that I will use. However, I want to do inpainting a little bit differently this time. Before I go ahead with this video, we need to have the segs talk. To those who have never had segs in their workflow before, it is a comprehensive data format which can contain not only the mask, but also control net wrapper. You can add IP adapter to it. So they carry quite a bit of information. Now, if I do a quick preview of it, so I'm just going to drag this here and then choose Segs Preview and then set this here and then run. You can see that my mask is now here. However, if I reduce the crop factor, it allows me to zoom in and focus on the bit I want in more detail. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to look for a detailer node. I will choose the fourth one from the top. Use image as input, connect this bit here. And lastly, I need to add cat to the positive prompt. So I click here and then I choose from basic pipe, then double click, TOB to basic pipe, connect all of these and then connect it to the detailer. And here I can edit my positive prompt. So from clip, I drag here and choose clip text encode. I can call this new positive prompt and then connect it to the positive. Now we can even do this. My new positive prompt is going to be cat sitting on kitchen bench. Here for randomize, I will change to fixed, change my sampler, reduce this one to 768 and make the noise 1. Because after all, we're trying to replace empty kitchen bench with a kitchen bench with a cat there. And because our checkpoint is in painting model, I am going to enable this bit here. And let's see the output. And there's the kitty cat. We will end it here. Thank you for watching. If you want more videos on sex education, make sure to like and subscribe. Until then, class dismissed.